In this understanding, existential therapy has the aim to help ourselves and others, no distinction by pathology or whatever, to help human beings to come to a full and real being. What is, in other words, existence. I assume, and Stephen, please correct me if I'm wrong, that we could all agree up to this level. Existential therapy turns around existence, and existence means a full and real being, to become a real human being. And this needs, of course, an understanding what being human means. And from here on, the differences start between the existential understandings of therapy. In our existential analysis Vienna style, being human means coming to a full being and realizing such means dealing with being a person. We use the term person. Many of you don't like that term, but we can define it and understand what is meant with Dasein and persons. They are not so different, but there are different aspects, of course. And person includes actualization of our freedom in our understanding of person in a responsible and dialogical open way. So, being really fully a human being, being really there means to be person in the sense of making use of the freedom in a responsible and dialogical open way. This is the concept of Dasein underlying it. Or Ernesto's relational aspect. For the actualization, we in our society have a theory or a thinking that the actualization needs a dealing with the dimensions of existence, which are close to Binswanger's four Welten, the ontic dimension, the world, the actuality, the conditions, the facticity, this being able to be. Existential therapy wants to help people and ourselves to be really there. This means to be, it means primarily to work on that ontological basis of being able to be, and the axiological dimension. Life, value, feelings, relation, to help people to like to be, to relate to their lives, to their being there. And the Eigenwelt, in a dialogical context, is an ethical dimension. Being oneself, person, authentic, in encounter, looking at if what I'm allowed to be, if I may be that way, if I feel that this is permitted, that this is authentic, that it is really me, and we have an inner resonance for that. And of course, there is a dimension, a fourth dimension, after world and the ontic, the axiological, the ethic, the meaning dimension, the becoming, the field of activity, the context relatedness, the harmonizing with what is given. This is the question of what we are asked for, what we should do, what we maybe even ought to do as human beings. And as a result, when I can be there and I like to be there and I resonate with myself and with the other, attuned to the other, and I see the development of becoming according to me, then I am really free. Then I can say, I really will. I will out of my, let's try the term, essence, which is person for us, which is in a constant way of responding to what is there in the inner world and in the outer world. So the existence, therefore, is understood, and this is our proposition, as the responsible realization of human freedom by making decisions on the basis of perceived capacities and possibilities, values, moral conscience, and meaning and becoming. Therefore, and I agree here with many in that discussion, that email discussion, for instance, with Dmitry Leontief, who also wrote it, that we could try to make the definition short as a basic definition. Existential therapy, counseling, and psychotherapy aims to help people to come to a real being there in the full sense of a human being. This is a very general definition, of course, but maybe one in which we can agree. To be really there in the full sense of a human being. Frankl has seen the essence of existence in living one's, he wrote it explicitly, one's responsibility. He always said that logotherapy aims to help people to find their responsibility. This was on the top. And in this way, the way to find this responsibility is his concept of meaning. So for Frankl, finding one's responsibility and finding one's meaning was the essence, or was the definition of his existential approach. And we would say, because terms change over the decades, we would say the essence of existence is being. I think most of us could agree with that. Is the essence of existence is being, fully being. This is, of course, a very soberly and short definition, therefore hard to understand. In existential analysis, and I conclude, I close with that, we have a processual definition, avoiding the contents. We say existential analysis, our Vienna existential analysis, means to help people to come to an emotionally free experience, that we are open enough, this principle phenomenological openness, to an emotional, that we can feel and are not blocked in our feelings and reactive and coping reactions and psychodynamics, but that we can breathe freely in our emotionality and come to an authentic position. This free emotionality is basic to come to an authentic position and give the responses, dealing with oneself and the other and the world in a responsible way. So, thank you. This is the time.